Every woman, regardless of her ability, deserves to have consistent preventative health care and education. Only a moderate number of women with disabilities receive these basic services. In this underserved and highly diverse population, national data shows lower rates of regular breast screening, but they are just as susceptible to breast cancer as women overall. These women aren't receiving repeat mammograms as often as they should. This is the invisible population of women's health. Disability is a broad term that refers generally to a limitation in physical or mental function caused by one or more health conditions. 28 million U.S. women with disabilities represent a large and growing sector of the population. Of women 65 and over, 43% are living with a disability. The likelihood of having a disability increases with age. Therefore, the number of women with disabilities can be expected to grow in the coming decades.
I consider myself a breast cancer survivor. It's been 20 years post. I've had like three careers in the course of my life. I was a paralegal, a psychotherapist, I have an MA in psychology, and a dancer, wheelchair style. I am a fully human person. And that I'm not just this body that they're going to be dealing with. For me, there's a big concern that the mammography technician have the skills to get a really good picture without having to take the picture three or four times. I guess I'm a regular and people do know me, and they have been able to get decent pictures the first time.
I am a wife. A mama, writer, and educator. I have a book published. People make a lot of assumptions about me based on what they see. Some help providers may think I can't talk, or maybe afraid that they won't understand me. So they may talk to my attendant rather than to me. Once they get comfortable with me and realize that I'm just like any other person they encounter, then it becomes easier.
It's very important that the technologists know how to deal with women with disabilities such as a stroke. It helps to communicate with the technologist. Now with the stroke, I have to have someone help me and place my arm on the machine in a position where it won't interfere with the mammogram itself.
Look, you may see my wheelchair first, but there's more to me than just that. This mammogram is important to me. It's long overdue, and it should have been done about 3 years ago. But I was concerned about being able to hold a pose long enough for the x-ray. But really, the bottom line is, I want to be treated like a person, not a problem.
All very different. It's my world experience that disability is so variable, so that we have to be treated very much as unique individuals, and people need to ask us questions and learn about us and get to know us as people, and in the process of working with us. It's definitely a collaborative experience, especially when working with folks with disabilities.
My oldest sister had passed away from breast cancer, and I believe, it's not just for my because of my sister. I believe every woman should have a mammogram. It's important because a lot of the women, even myself, we don't always examine our breasts the way that we should.
I find that when I have a good experience having a mammogram, I tend to feel better about going back. The technologists and the people who work in the office have to remember that I am somebody. Wife, somebody's mother, somebody's friend, and they all care about me, and they don't want to lose me, so they want me to be healthy and have the best mammogram I can possibly have.